here, the singers are back again. We're going to start with an arrangement of a Polynesian folk song. Polynesian music is becoming a little bit more of a thing in the choral world, and there are more composers who are arranging Polynesian folk songs and this kind of thing. This one happens to be from New Zealand, which is the native, largest native population in New Zealand. It's called the Maori, or Maori, and they're part of the whole Polynesian history and culture. And so this is Bokare Kare Ana, and as you can see in your program, there's a translation, and as you can see, it's a love song from a man to a woman, and I want to read you the story. Bokare Kare Ana is a love song from the Te Awara tribe district of New Zealand. It celebrates the famous story of Hine Amoa, a Maori princess who was in love with Tutaneki, a common warrior who lived on an island in Lake Rotorua, 9 miles from shore. And you'll hear the choir sing that word, Rotorua. Because of the difference in their social status, Hine Amoa's father would not allow Tutaneki to court his daughter. The warrior would visit the princess' community for Maori gatherings and ceremonies, and they would meet secretly. When at home on his island, Tutaneki would serenade his lover each evening by playing his flute, and the sound would travel across the water to where the princess would listen. Because the chief knew that his daughter would like to go to the warrior, he took the precaution of packing away the canoes every night so that she could not escape. One night, when Hine Amoa could bear it no longer, she decided to swim the 9 miles to her warrior's island, supported by branches under her arms to keep her afloat. She made it safely to the island, and the next day when her parents arrived, it was too late, and they had to allow the marriage. Many tribes of the Rotorua region developed from the descendants of this couple. Of course, this is a myth. It's not literally true, but it's a wonderful story. Bokare Kare Ana.
Come on.
we do our final piece, I want to make you aware of a couple more events that are happening in our department this semester. We have a symphonic band concert on Thursday, November 16th. And we also have the Magical Feast, which this group will present December 1st and 2nd. And that is a ticketed event. It's only $20. It's been $20 for a long time, so the price hasn't gone up. And it's a dinner and magical costumes and a wonderful Renaissance kind of atmosphere and singing and comedy and a nice evening of entertainment. So if you're interested in that event, all you have to do is call and you'll find my number on the website, or if you're interested in it this evening, maybe you can ask me for that. I can get that for you. So anyway, we'll finish with an arrangement of the spirituals, of course, were songs sung by the slaves, particularly in their religious experiences. And long about 1870s or so, spirituals started to become arranged as choral music, as four-part choral arrangements. The first really noteworthy group that was doing that was from Fisk University in Tennessee, the Fisk Jubilee Singers, which was an African-American group, actually. And today, spirituals have remained a staple of our repertoire, and they're usually lively, not always, sometimes they're slow, but a lot of fun. So hope you enjoy a great getting up morning.